Bonjour.
Hello.
Dans les années 50,
in the 1950s in Rio de Janeiro, there were young musicians who created a new wave of music called Bossa Nova.
La Bossa Nova.
Avec une guitare on the beach, a few friends, some whiskey, were all that was needed. They began writing songs on beautiful poems about beautiful girls and about the beautiful and paradise location of the Bay of Rio de Janeiro. What's interesting for us here is how we'll be imitating a guitar on the piano. We'll also be playing some upright bass, so as to have a small orchestra in your hands. The fundamental element of bossa nova is rhythm. There's a bass rhythm, which we'll use as reference, and around which we'll be doing some rhythmic variations. First of all, there's the bass. We're in F major. The bass imitates the sordo, the bass drum used in samba. As you can see, this note is played very staccato. There's no need to play loud. Bossa nova is a very relaxed kind of music. First we have four chords on the beat, followed by three chords off the beat, which gives us
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, et 2, et 3, et 4, et 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, et 2, et 3, et 4.
So I'll be putting both hands together, along with the bass, which goes like this. And here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, et 2, et 3, et 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, et 2, et 3, et 4. Tit, 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 tit. Et là, très calme.
It's like being relaxed. In front of the sea, the weather is beautiful. The sun is setting and we're feeling good.
Un peu plus de legato.
A bit more legato.
Des variations.
And some variations.
Ma basse bouge pas.
But my bass is always solid.
Très bien.
Alright, so on this chord, F major 6, I'm going to begin playing the melody for Antonio Carlos Jobim's famous song, The Girl from Ipanema. Harmonically, bossa nova music is fairly rich and complex. It's inspired by jazz, but also by romantic music, most notably Chopin. We have a few jazz chords. The first is F major 7, so we're going to try to make things simpler, since we're going to be playing bass notes, as well as chords, just like a guitar would, as well as a melody, just like a singer would. Us pianists can do this, since our instrument is like an orchestra. This is one of the big challenges of being a pianist, as well as one of the great pleasures of the instrument. Here the melody goes. I'll use the bass note F. And two other notes.
Deux notes, la tierce, par exemple, et la quinte.
For example, the third and the fifth, A and C. And the melody is on the ninth.
Sur la neuvième, c'était ça l'invention.
That was Jobim's invention at the time. And it sounds like this.
Là, je change
d'accord, c'est un sol 7. We'll change the chord. It's a G7.
Si mi sol en haut.
I'm going to use B, E, and G on top, which becomes F, B, E. The right hand always has three notes. It's well enough for us. And now G minor.
The
G is flat 7, flat 5, since we have a C natural. And here I'm going to do what we call a turnaround in jazz.
A turnaround in jazz. La minor 7.
A minor.
Ré 7.
D7. While always keeping the C, G minor 7. C7, I can also add the B-flat, and here's the turnaround again, repeated.
En boucle.
Repeated. I strongly recommend that you play the turnaround in several keys and transpose it. The turnaround is the base of jazz chords. The bridge modulates to G flat major. It's very simple. All you need to do is play G flat on the bass, and F, and a third. F is the seventh, B flat is the third, and the F on the melody is also the seventh. There you are. This approach to bossa nova may take you some time to master, since you need to spend a little while assimilating the basic rhythm on F major. And then there's the turnaround, after which you can add the melody and the chords. It takes some patience, but the result is well worth the time and effort.